In this video, we'll discuss the idea of half-life, in particular for a first-order reaction, where the idea is that half-life is the time for half of the amount present to react. And half-life is also used for radioactive decay. So if we think of a batch reactor and a first-order reaction, And let's look at the simple case where we're looking at a constant volume, a constant density system. So the batch reactor equation, which is change in total number of moles respect to time, is a rate of reaction, which is a rate constant, a concentration. For a first order reaction, remember the negative sign is here because the number of moles of A is decreasing with time if we're looking at a reaction of A goes to B. Now, the number of moles is the concentration times the volume, and I left something out here. There has to be a volume here. Make the units consistent. This is the rate of reaction per volume, so we need a total volume of the reactor contents. If we now substitute for the number of moles in terms of concentration and volume, and we assume constant volume, then we can take the volume outside the derivative sign and cancel it, and we have the simplified equation for a constant volume batch reactor, which we can separate variables and integrate. And the concentration at any given time is the initial concentration times e to the minus kt. So what we're going to look at, we're going to look at a simple example, and we're going to use the rate constant that makes the numbers come out relatively nice values. So rate constant per minute, first order reaction, the units are inverse time. If I look at the concentration at any given time, let's just say it's moles per cubic meter and time in minutes, and suppose we start out with a concentration of 16 at time zero. So this is our Ca0 value. If I substitute the numbers in, turns out the concentration is 8 at 5 minutes. So the idea, we can do the calculations, but the idea of half-life is in 5 minutes, half the material reacted, so the half-life T1/2 is 5 minutes. So that means for half of what's remaining to react to go down to a concentration of 4, take another 5 minutes to be a total of 10 minutes. To go down to 2, take another 5 minutes, be 15. Go down to 1, another 5 minutes. This is the idea of half-life. Whatever amount is there, half-life is the time for half of that to react, or whatever concentration is there. So for an example, when we look at something like trying to remove a pollutant and getting reactant to a low concentration, and for these same kinetics, if we want to react 90% away, so 90% of A is reacted. So Ca is 1/10 of Ca0, then substituting into Ca is Ca0 e to the minus kt, and k is 0.139 minutes to minus 1. To react 90%, the time is 16.5 minutes. So now react 90% of what's remaining. Right. To go to 99%, it's going to take an additional 16.5 minutes. And to react now 90% of what's left, so we're going to go to 99.9%. Again, it's an additional 16.5 minutes. So this is a property of first order reaction. To get that last amount takes same time as to get the very large amount, if you want to look at it that way. As the concentration goes down, the rate is slower, and for first order reaction it becomes a very simple type relation. So just to reiterate, we're talking about half-life. If you look at these equations, K is 0.139, the half-life is 5. Yeah, let's write it down here. The half-life, it turns out, if you substitute in, is just a log of 2, natural log, divided by the rate constant. And that's for a first order reaction.